which Tomas has found. He kisses again, goes off happy, sells everything he owns, and buys the fruit. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he finds one of great value, he goes and sells everything he owns and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a dragnet cast into the sea that brings in a load of all kinds. When it is full, the fishermen hauls it ashore. Then, sitting down, they collect the good ones in a basket and throw away those that are no use. This is how it will be at the end of time. The angels will appear and separate the wicked from the just, to throw them into the blazing furnace where they will be weeping and grinding of teeth. Have you understood all this? They said, yes. And he said to them, well then, every scribe who becomes a disciple of the kingdom of heaven is like a householder who brings out from his storeroom things both new and old. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
This morning, we are celebrating the 17th Sunday in ordinary time. And the readings talk about wisdom. Wisdom. What is wisdom in Greek?
Bravo.
Bravo. If you don't know the wisdom in Greek, then I will send all of you to Greenia. Wisdom is something that everybody has to have. If you are not wise enough in life, they will always deceive you. For example, you are working on your employees. You need to be wise, open your eyes. You do your work faithfully. So at the end of the month, what do you expect from your employer?
Your salary.
If he doesn't give you, it means that maybe you are not wise enough. Maybe you didn't do your work. But if you do your work wisely, he has the right to give you your salary. You have to open your eyes. Wisdom, wise. That is why W-I-S-E, wise. Ask yourself, are you wise enough to manage your affairs, or somebody is the one managing for you? Before we choose somebody to become a barangay captain, or a mayor, or a government president, or a leader, we need to see in him the qualities. The first one is wisdom, because without wisdom, you cannot marry the barangay which has been entrusted to you, the area which you are the captain. And so every barangay captain, or every leader, or every president, you need to have this wisdom in order to govern the people that God has given to you. And so in the first reading, we heard from the first reading from the book of Kings, a man, what is the name of that man whom God chose him to succeed his father? Who is the name of that man? What is the name of the king in the first reading who succeeded his father?
Solomon.
King Solomon. Okay? King, not King Kuya. King Solomon. Or King Jude. No. King Solomon. He was a king in Israel. And then God asked him, what do you want me to do for you? Supposing you are a king, or supposing you are the paradise of king, and God asked you, what do you want me to do for you? What will you tell God? What will you tell God?
Good leadership.
You will say that, but I'm sure a lot of them we shall not say like that. We shall say, Lord, let me have a lot of money. No? Who doesn't like money? If you don't like money, then I don't know. You will tell God, Lord, let me have a lot of money. Or if you are Babayero, you tell God, let me have a lot of wives. Or if you are somebody who doesn't respect anything, you say, Lord, let me become Mayama. Proud. We always ask from God the things that are not necessary for us. But in God, we need to ask for wisdom, something that will help us to know, to live our life happily, in order to discover the treasure God has for us. You know, when you discover something precious in your life, it's like you have discovered something which is incredible. In Italian, you hear them saying, oh, tesoro mio, tesoro mio, tesoro means treasure. My treasure, something that you hold it to your heart, something that you love it. Mahal po. Mahal na mahal na kita. If you say this, it means that you are saying it from the bottom of your heart. You cannot say this to an enemy. Enemy, mahal po. Mahal na de kita. No. I hope you understand. You say mahal kita to the one you love. I love you to the one you love. You don't say mahal to your enemy. Because if you say mahal, mahal, nothing, kita, and your enemy will respond, that enemy will fight behind you and make case made for you, and then it will destroy you. And so, if you discover something good, the treasure in your life, you have to hold firm to your heart. That is what happened in the gospel of today. Jesus Christ told the crowds, now listen to another parable. The kingdom of heaven, we know the kingdom. The kingdom is the kingdom of love, the kingdom of justice, and the kingdom of peace. Jesus Christ explains how the kingdom of God looks like. If you come to me and say, Father, how does heaven look like? Heaven. I have never gone to heaven before. Neither do you. We have you gone to heaven before? But we know that heaven, there is always peace. You know that. Heaven, there is no chismet. Heaven, there is no fight. Heaven, there is no backbiting. Heaven, there is no dinubwa. Heaven, there is no ampalaya. Heaven, there is no talong. And so heaven is a place where everything is perfect. Okay? So if you compare heaven and earth, they're totally different. So if you come to me and say, Father, how does the heaven look like? And Jesus Christ explained, the kingdom of heaven is like, and then he says, a man who discovers a treasure in the field. He hides it and go and sell everything that he owns. What does he sell? Maybe he will sell the cattle, he will sell the kidney, he will sell the ikis and the gas, he will sell everything that he owns and come and buy the field and have a lot of money to come and buy. Another one is this. The heaven is like a man, a merchant looking for a nice pearl. You know what is a pearl? Like a jewel. If he finds one, he goes and sells everything he wants and come and buy the pearl. So it's like a young boy or a young girl discovering for himself or for herself a beautiful wife or handsome husband. What do? You try to date the person slowly, slowly. You try to catch the heart of the person. You try to invite the person. If the person likes a tea, you say, hello, you want a cup of tea? Then you invite the person to Starbucks. You go and buy a tea for the person. So by drinking tea, slowly, slowly, you win the heart of the person. It means that you buy the person's heart. You see? So when you discover something good, you try to win the person by inviting the person.
If the person is
not in love with you group in the church, you invite her, come to the choir, come and sing with the choir, or come to the Lashada, or come to the Divine Mercy. Then from there, you begin from one, then number two, then number three, number four, you see that you are here making, we are kind of taking you as my Maha, I will love you, I will honor you until the day, then you can surpass. This is how it is. You cannot just wake up and say, hey, come and marry me, please marry me, I love you, marry me. What kind of life is this? This is what is happening in our world of today. My dear friend, when you discover a treasure, pray over it. Your wife can become your treasure. Your husband can become your treasure. Your brothers and sisters can become your treasure. But pray over it. But the main treasure that we are talking about is the treasure of heaven.
Amen.
I know, I believe that all of us, we want to go to heaven. No?
Yes.
So if you want to go to heaven, you have to do?
Pray always.
Ask yourself. Ask yourself now that today, if God calls me, can I go to heaven?
A good servant of God.
I know, if you want to go to the Philippines, I'll tell you, go to where Calum, why you're taking, go to Lanaka and fly to Manila, at International Airport. That's all, finish. But to go to heaven, it's not like that. To go to heaven, it's not like that. You don't buy your ticket, you go to heaven with a clean hand and pure hands. Ask yourself, do you have a pure hands? Can you climb the mountain of the Lord? If you cannot, then don't delay. Start now. Because now we don't know what this pandemic. We know now. Today is known. But tomorrow is unknown. So if you think, though, let me wait. Tomorrow will never come. And then you will find yourself in the hell. And there will be those who will be thrown there for the grinding of teeth. So let us all pray this holy mass, that as we have discovered the treasure of Jesus Christ, who is the way, the truth, and the life, may he lead all of us to the Father, so that we can see God face to face when we go to heaven. Then everything will be perfect. God, heaven, there is no corona. Heaven, there is no virus. Heaven, there is no COVID-19. Heaven, there is always peace, joy, and love forever and ever. Amen.
I believe in one God.